Hi everyone, welcome to Rockstar Health and Fitness. We're here at the House of Rock in Santa Monica, and today's guest is a legend in the dance music scene, a trend-setting icon, an incredibly talented artist, and I absolutely love her style. We're here with Kerli. Hi, we're here with Kerli. Hi, Kerli.
Hey.
One of my favorite things about you is your incredible style. Where do you get your style sense from?
I don't know. I guess it's
match.
Just like a mix and match of like 90s Euro trash with some ethereal characters and anime and I don't know, you name it. I mean, I shop at like Ross and thrift stores and eBay and just anything.
If it
goes,
catches your eye, it works.
Yeah.
And you make your own clothes sometimes too, don't you?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
That's a good skill.
Especially for videos, you know, because I can never like find, I have this fantastical characters in my head that I want to create, so I usually just like sketch it.
Your videos are fantastic. And my office at Island Def Jam is right down the hall from Chris Anacute, who A&R'd your record.
Mm-hmm.
So I hear it all the time. I've heard every remix, I've heard the song on repeat, and I absolutely love it.
Oh my god, you're just saying that.
No!
You must be hating and you're like,
you know what? I wouldn't
damn.
Have said anything. I would have just been like, hey, good luck with the new single.
Yeah, good luck with the single. That was nice.
So anyway, obviously with your busy schedule, I'm sure health and fitness is an important part of it. I hope, because that's why you're here.
Yes. Yes, absolutely.
All right, well, are you ready to show us a few things? Maybe something in the kitchen and maybe your favorite workout?
Yeah,
let's go. Mm-hmm. See you loud. Hi, we're here in the kitchen segment with Kerli.
Hey.
Excited to see what we're gonna make.
Okay. So we're gonna make one of my favorite easy snacks to make. All my friends love it. They make me do it every time they come over.
And I love that it's easy. That's my favorite part.
It's super easy. The only thing that actually takes time is making this couscous. It's like a couscous bowl. But that takes like 5 minutes. All you have to do is just boil some water and dump the couscous in there.
Just like pasta?
No, it's even easier.
Easier?
You don't even boil it. Like, you just boil the water and then you put the couscous in and let it sit under a cover like for 3 minutes and it's done. Now we have the couscous. So, also putting some arugula.
Okay.
In there. This is really yummy.
Wow.
Also, some tomatoes. I think the tomato juice adds to the
flavor. Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah. Avocados.
Yes. I put those on everything.
Me too.
One of the superfoods.
Yeah. Okay, so avocado.
Tomatoes, couscous, arugula.
Arugula, couscous, avocado, tomatoes. Then to add a little guilt to the whole thing.
That's the best part.
Because otherwise it's too good to be true. Just adding some Parmesan cheese.
Perfect. One of my favorites. Very great flavor.
So good. It just makes this whole thing alive. A little bit of olive oil.
I see why your friends always want you to make this.
Well, you haven't even tasted it yet.
I can tell already. It's
in
all
Estonia,
my favorite things.
In Estonia, we have this saying, don't get too happy before the night is over.
What is Estonia like, by the way?
Well, you know what I just told you, the saying. So it's kind of like the opposite of the American culture.
Uh-oh.
You know, because here people are very much like, yes, you can do anything, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, if your child has talent, the whole family will move to Hollywood.
Right.
In Estonia, hell no. Lemon for taste. Sea salt. And we're ready.
Mix it up and you're ready to go.
Yeah.
All right, there you go. Fantastic. We can't wait to try it. And are you ready to show us something in the fitness segment?
Yes.
All right, we got that coming up next. We're here in the fitness segment with Kerli, and we have a special treat today.
Yeah, fitness.
I'm excited to learn this.
It's not exactly fitness, yeah?
But it's part of a healthy lifestyle, so it makes sense, right?
Yeah, this thing that I'm gonna show you guys is actually one of the most amazing tools that I have found for myself, because I'm really busy and intense, so it's really hard for me to just like get my mind to shut down. So I found this amazing tool. It's called breathwork, and it's really, really easy. So don't look at this right now, because
comfortable.
This chair is just so great. But in ideal world, I'm laying flat right now. And the breath itself, you're supposed to actually take a blanket as well.
Okay.
Because you're gonna get hot, you're gonna get cold, the energy starts moving in your body.
Okay, so you're lying flat.
You're lying flat, and what you do is, for 20 minutes, you take in two breaths and out one breath. And you do it all through your mouth. And you start lower.
So you like breathe in, like push belly out, open the nose.
First breath in your diaphragm, then you move higher to your chest, and then you breathe out. And just get a good tempo.
And you almost think of it as
and
like
all through your mouth. All through your mouth.
With your mouth open?
With your mouth, yeah. You can almost imagine it as a circle as well, because that might make it easier.
One thing I struggle with in any sort of breathwork is my mind starts going crazy.
Yeah. So that's the thing. So this what this type of breathwork does, so flat surface, two breaths in, one breath out through your mouth. Get yourself a blanket, because you'll probably get really cold and really hot, and energy starts moving in your body. You start feeling your hands tingling, your feet tingling, your mouth, if there are some things that you've left unsaid.
Wow.
It's just all energy, your throat, anywhere you have a blockage. Actually, I started doing breath work like a year ago, and after that, I have a lot less worry. I have more trust.
Wow.
I'm more leveled. I used to be more like higher lows and higher highs, lower lows and higher highs. Now I just have the highs, but I don't really like dip anymore the same way. So it changed my life.
It's your whole life.
Yeah.
Wow, why can't we
and
to try
I've been bringing friends to all these breathing circles, and some people have really found like this thing for them that they actually actively do, so.
One thing too I just want to ask you mm-hmm. about, I love how you've kind of named your fans the Moon Children, mm-hmm. right? What can you tell us about the Moon Children before we wrap up?
The Moon Children is really funny. When I first moved to America like 6 years ago, I started just doing these little crazy YouTube rants about life, and I was really conflicted and depressed kind of person, so I just, life didn't make sense, so I started like posting all this inspirational rant crazy videos, and the bunch of kids just started connecting with it, and I was like, oh wow, we kind of have this community together, and it's like they gave really good points and really like, I don't know, somehow like this group of people was formed, and now it's just like growing and growing and growing. And And it's, I wouldn't really call the Moon Children my fans. It's just we mark ourselves with these three dots.
Oh, what do they mean?
They stand for integrity, love, and unity.
Wow.
So it's just like this little artistic community that, you know, we just try to inspire each other. And I also talk about, you know, some heavier things, and they have opinions, and they have opinions about like, even when I play with the style, like I sometimes let them pick my next hair color, and
that's great.
So that it's
keep
more like
involved.
An interactive community. Yeah.
Fantastic. Well, sign me up.
Yeah.
And thanks for
You're
stopping
in.
By. It
Thank
was really
you.
Fun having you here today
Thank
too.
You.
And be on the lookout for Kerli's new album, and be sure and get her single, The Lucky Ones, on iTunes. We'll see you next week, and until then, remember, it's not a choice, it's a lifestyle.
That's right. Walking on air, you feel this, unless you kill me.